Hey, what's up? My name is Adam, and in this video, I'm gonna give you a Gumroad tutorial. We're gonna cover everything that you need to know about the strategy, what to do pre-launch, successful Gumroad launches, and successful Gumroad creators, a checklist of things you need to know about creating a product, the setup process, and lastly, best practices to keep in mind as you go through your journey being a creator on Gumroad. At the very end of the video, I will also be sharing a crazy bonus idea for how to use Gumroad. If this is your first time on the Kahana channel, I just wanted to say welcome. We're super excited to have you here. And if you're a returning viewer, welcome back. We missed you. I have to admit, I'm a little bit sick right now, so I want to apologize if my voice sounds a bit hollow. We're gonna do our best. Now, let's just dive right into the video. It's important to note that you can create a Gumroad account for free, and there's really no limit to what you can sell on Gumroad. You can start earning money, and as you earn money, Gumroad charges a transaction fee for the overall product sales that you incur. Depending on how much you've sold, Gumroad will take a variable percentage that scales with your overall earnings. You may be wondering to yourself, how do you create a good strategy for Gumroad? My friend Jonathan ran some numbers and did an experiment which analyzed the top 50 products in a category, and he identified some patterns that you're gonna wanna know about. We'll explain the results that we found right now.
Hey, Jonathan here. Just wanted to share some interesting analysis that we put together around Gumroad and just taking a quick look at the Gumroad algorithm and what performs well. So what you're looking at right here is the top 50 ranked products in the business and money category on Gumroad. So just what shows up as positions 1 through 50 in the best product section. Ran some numbers and just wanted to see if we could glean any insights on how the algorithm works and what performs well on Gumroad. And we did find a couple of data points that were pretty interesting. We'll start right here. And as you can see, over 60% of the products in the top 50 are one-time payment products, so that aren't associated with a recurring subscription fee to access. And that's very likely because most of the products on Gumroad simply happen to be one-time payment products. But what's interesting about this is that it represents an opportunity to create high quality subscription products to rank higher and stand out from some of these one-time payment products. Another interesting trend that we noticed is when we broke out the data into just the top 25, so the first half of this group, positions 1 through 25, and then the second half of the group, positions 26 through 50, it looks like recurring subscription products that are ranked in the top 25 had a much higher average price point, close to $440 per month, than the top 26 to 50, which just had an average price point of $46 per month. And that was something we thought was extremely interesting because it shows that the algorithm may lean in favor of more expensive monthly products, which certainly would make sense because based on Gumroad's pricing structure, they make more money the more expensive something is. And so it would certainly not be out of the question that they would try and push high quality products that have a higher price point. This is just one group of data. It's a small sample size, but it definitely was interesting enough that we thought you might be interested in hearing about it. And it seems like there is a bit of a trend that you can glean from this. So we definitely think there is an opportunity to create high quality, high price point, recurring subscription products. And there you have it. Cheers.
When you're designing your pre-launch strategy, there's a couple things to keep in mind. First off, Gumroad is getting more and more competitive. This data from Exploding Topics shows just how much interest there really is. Have some fun. Go on the Gumroad Discover page and look at the categories and subcategories that currently exist within your space, and think about the products that currently exist in your category. These are going to provide great inspiration for you. This is critical when it comes to thinking about your pricing strategy, how to structure your product, and its benefits. Let's quickly analyze a best-selling product in its category. This product about cold email mastery has been rated over 800 times with an average rating of 5 stars and is priced at $450 at the time of this recording. When you look at the product page, you will see a long list of benefits of purchasing the product, and an even longer list of social proof and customer reviews. Getting into more specific examples, I interviewed a Gumroad creator who has quickly generated over $2,000 of lifetime sales from 20,000 customers. If you're wondering about how he accomplished that, well, he actually told me in the interview, and I turned it into a checklist. Here it is. 1. Use a GIF as your product cover photo to improve click-through rates. 2. Create a product backup so you never lose anything, just in case something happens. 3. Encourage 5-star ratings and follow up with your customers. 4. Show social proof by any means necessary, screenshots, quotes, etc. 5. Send a launch email to incentivize sharing and downloading. 6. Create email sequences using Gumroad's workflow functionality. 7. Don't forget to relaunch whenever you can, whenever you update your product or make an enhancement. 8. Automate everything with Zapier, including importation of email lists. 9. Communicate, communicate, communicate. If you look at his Gumroad page, you'll see that his products have inspiring GIFs and designs, really showcasing the value of all of the products, and they create an ecosystem for productivity and organization. I think it's really, really impressive, and you should check it out for inspiration. You can get really creative when it comes to Gumroad products. For example, TheVeller created a 330 plus Notion resources archive to help people get started learning Notion. All of this was just information that he gathered over the course of learning Notion himself, and he created a product out of it and put it on Gumroad. When I interviewed him, he said that Gumroad is basically like a blue ocean. There's so many possibilities to what you can do, and that's what makes it fun. Gumroad also opens up a lot of opportunities to collaborate. We collaborated directly with TheVeller to create a Notion blog template product that was launched on Gumroad, and we even made a YouTube video about the original template. Set up your Gumroad product by going step by step through the entire workflow. First, select which type of product you're going to use. Here I just use a digital product, give it a name, set a price, then move on to the next steps. From here, fill out information about the product, including your image, various pieces of information, including your description, as well as checkout information. Set up automated emails to engage with your audience. From the new workflow section, you can set trigger values, the audience that will receive certain emails, and multiple sequences. This is a major feature of Gumroad that many creators don't take advantage of, so make sure you play around with it and cater it to your needs. It's a great way to nurture your customer email lists. I also recommend that you check out the ability to connect your social profiles, which will make it easier for you to be discovered. You can connect with PayPal if you already have a PayPal account, and you can also connect your custom domain if you want to connect your Gumroad with your web presence, and you can also add Google Analytics as a way to evaluate your performance over time, as well as connect with the Gumroad API, which is an extremely powerful API if you're a developer. You can also set up an affiliate signup form, which allows anybody to request an affiliate link where they'll earn a commission for promoting and distributing your product. It's honestly a win-win, and you should totally check it out. Now, with all that out of the way, I just wanted to mention three best practices to keep in mind as you go through your journey on Gumroad. The first one would be, remember that in the grand scheme of things, Gumroad isn't a huge deal, and it's not a huge step in being a creator. You're building an entire ecosystem of content and products, so keep it simple, have fun when you're using Gumroad, and don't take it too seriously. The second best practice would be, don't get too discouraged if your product launch doesn't go as you think it should. You can always relaunch and do it again and see what happens. The third would be creative. Gumroad doesn't have every single category for you. It doesn't recommend every single product that you could ultimately try to build. But if you have an idea of something that could work, just go for it. Just try it. It's always interesting to see new products showing up on Gumroad. So take a chance, take a flyer, and be creative. That's ultimately going to help you win as a creator on Gumroad and as a creator in any platform. If you're still with me, I wanted to take the opportunity to pitch you a bonus idea that I had. So first off, just going back to the research that Jonathan did and the takeaways that we learned, it seems like Gumroad prioritizes high ticket products that are subscription based. So I want to invite you to collaborate with me and build a product that is subscription-based, that is priced, that we can launch on Gumroad. The idea that I have is to create a hub of content and files that we add to on an ongoing basis that allows people to learn about topics of interest. So we can look at trending topics in multiple industries, whatever interests us most, whatever we're super curious about, pull together resources, and then gather it into a hub and charge for access to that through Gumroad. I think this would be an awesome experiment to run on Gumroad. So if you're interested in getting involved, let me know in the comments or hit me up. If you enjoyed this content and you haven't already, please smash that like button, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell to get notifications whenever we drop a new video. We're trying to get to 1,000 subscribers in the next 2 weeks, so you can really help us by supporting the channel. Hope you have a great rest of your day. See you tomorrow.